That's the most accurate description for this spot in South Dakota. The nearest town is 30 minutes away. There is no mobile connectivity, just a dirt road and one signpost. It's a different story underground, though.
Right now, all the framing is done. So what we're doing is we're putting on the paneling, which finishes it off. We've started, as you can see, each one is going to be cut to conform to the radius of the concrete.
Scott Robertson works for Vivos, the company that owns the bunkers. Robert Vecino is its CEO.
Anyway, so this is an 18-square-mile property. There's 575 former military bunkers on the south side of the property. And on the north side, there's another 275.
The bunkers are on an army base built during World War II and were used to store bombs and munitions until the base closed in 1967. So they were built to be durable, and Vecino guarantees the covering doesn't let radiation pass through. And the best news, there is enough space for a big family if they can pay the price, $25,000 to have a bunker of their own. The model bunker has four bedrooms, a kitchen, a little movie theater, and even a small farm.
A greenhouse. We grow food in here. And we can also have fish in here, and that's called aquaponics.
Vecino is pretty confident this former U.S. military base is a safe spot. It's far from the ocean, so a tsunami is unlikely. And South Dakota isn't on the list for probable nuclear bomb targets. It even has the potential to be a city of the future. About 10,000 people will be able to hide in these bunkers. So in case of disaster, the only thing you need to do is to get to this remote part of the United States in time, find the right hill, and quickly lock yourself inside.